Welcome back to Unbiased Magic Reviews, the place you come to for the honest magic review you can count on. Today, I'm going to be doing a magic review for you guys. Big surprise. Hope you're having a good holiday season. We're going to be taking a quick look at Cyril Takayama's second Penguin Live lecture that came out this month.
Cyril continues to astound audiences with his engaging persona and mind-blowing magic. The last time he appeared here on Penguin Live, we talked about his incredible career and success, and he taught some pretty cool manipulation. And this time, he's returned to share some devastatingly clever routines and ideas, including one that was featured on one of his television specials. A borrowed quarter instantly penetrates into a sealed soda can chosen moments before.
One, two, three.
Oh, no way.
Wait. So you didn't hear anything
earlier,
right?
No, there was nothing there.
All right, pour it all out.
Plus, he talks about the challenges of finding a way to translate strong magic designed for television into a live performance. Then, he teaches you one of the greatest party tricks ever, a do-as-I-do where you teach the spectator to make cola vanish over their own head.
Three, go! And the cola disappears! What? Surprise!
Then, he brings the cola back using his own handling of a now classic effect, including all the details that make all the difference.
Here it fixes, then you can pour, and there you got yourself a nice big round of applause.
Yay!
And finally, if you're into manipulation, Cyril does not disappoint as he finishes by showing us his award-winning money production. He teaches the special fold and technique he uses to reliably produce one bill after another. With a bit of practice, of course. That's cool. You'll learn what it really takes to create, design, and perform astounding and original magic when you join Cyril right here at Penguin Live.
So you may have picked up Cyril's first Penguin Live lecture, which was more about stage magic. This one is more close-up, street magic, party magic. And as always, I'm going to give you guys my initial impressions, go over the routines that he teaches, and then give you some final thoughts. So I was really pleased with this live lecture. I liked how he centered it around soda can magic, really. Three out of the four effects involve a soda can, which was kind of nice. None of the magic really seems to be original to him. What you're really getting is he's really teaching you his experiences, his handlings of these effects, and some tips and ideas. He does go over in detail how he's turned a lot of this television magic into live magic that he could perform for people live, which I think that's the real value of the lecture. In the usual Penguin Live format, Dan Harlan is the host. And he's very energetic and he participates a lot in this lecture, which that's nice to see. And I overall thought it was a really good lecture. The first effect comes directly out of his television show, which is the coin in the can. And it's not often that you see a big television magician teaching you an effect that directly comes out of their television special. So the coin in the can, really, I think it became really popular when Wayne Huchin put out his impromptu version called Sinful. And I think it was David Blaine who actually performed that on television. And so in this version by Cyril, there's quite a bit of preparation involved. It's not impromptu, but what you're going to get is you're going to get a very convincing, squeaky clean looking coin being penetrated into a can, and the can immediately be examined 100% by the spectator. They're going to find a coin inside of it where there wasn't one before, apparently. So some things I really like about it is there's also an auditory illusion involved with it, which is great because the person can turn the can up and down initially, that all they hear is fluid inside of it. Immediately after the coin is penetrated into the can, now you immediately hand it to them, and now there's obviously something inside the can that wasn't there before. So it's a very clever method, and for that, there's quite a bit of preparation of that can. In the lecture, he spends about 40 minutes going over the preparation of the can itself. So I could see how a lot of people would not want to mess around with this, but obviously, the payoff is probably worth it. And this is the kind of effect that I could see. You could have that can planted in a place so it looks totally impromptu, even though it's not. Some things I think that he could have done better with this is I think he could have taught you alternative vanishes of the coin. I think that would have been better. And I think he should have probably gone over the idea of having a signed coin in the can, because I could easily see how this could be something like that. And I think on his TV special, he did do signed coin in the can. So it would be good if he actually had taught that variation of it, or at least give you some ideas of it. But otherwise, I thought it was still really good. This is definitely my favorite effect that he went over. He definitely goes over all the little tips, handling tips to help you so you don't run into any trouble if you want to try to perform this yourself. It's very exciting, especially because now you can perform a piece of magic that maybe somebody who you're performing it for has seen on television. That's really great. So the second effect is kind of like a continuation, because there you're going to have the soda poured into a cup, and it's more of a do as I do effect. But what happens is that you show the spectator that you can literally vanish the soda out of the cup that they're holding over their head instantly. So the method obviously is not original to him, and they do credit the original creators on the lecture, so that's good. It's very, very simple. Anyone could perform it. You might like it. So that's the second effect. The third effect and the last one that has to do with the soda can is the classic healed and sealed soda can, where you know you've already poured out the contents and the coin and the can is already kind of crushed. And what you do is you take the can and then you magically restore the can. You magically close the top of the can. And so that sealed and healed soda can effect, if I remember correctly, that's Anders Moden's effect. And so here Cyril just gives you his handling of it, some tips. He uses something a little different. But definitely, I thought that was good. It's definitely something that any of us probably would perform in the right situation. Again, this is like the kind of thing that you can have somebody plant that or help you to perform it, so that way you can make it look totally impromptu if you wanted to. Another excellent effect. And then finally, the last effect is his bill production, which actually that's John Gallo's Osaka bills. And he does go over it really quickly, so I don't think you could really learn it well from this lecture, although you can get the basic idea. If you do like this, I would recommend that you try to get your hand on John Gallo's old DVD called Osaka Bills, and I think that came out like in 2004. It's a long time ago now. I know it's been discontinued on different magic sites, so you're gonna have to probably buy it from somebody else that has it. But on that DVD, I remember, because I used to have it, he goes over very, very little types of tips that you're not going to get from the lecture. John Gallo goes over how you don't lose control of the stack. He gives you just his really nice close-up handling tips of how to do the production. And John Gallo goes over a routine, like a close-up routine that you can do with the production, where it appears that the bills are just appearing from nowhere. And then there's a nice ending where you end with two handfuls of bills instantly. So for those people that are interested in the bill production that you see here, I would recommend that you try to get your hands on John Gallo's DVD, because you're going to learn a lot more there. I think that here Cyril just basically scratched the surface of this. But you can see that it's extremely easy to do, because he immediately puts it in Dan Harlan's hands and just has him do it immediately. And he can do the basic production. But what's interesting is that Dan Harlan does kind of lose control of the stack. And that is something that is addressed directly in the John Gallo DVD to help you so you don't lose control of the stack. So my final thoughts for this is that I think if you enjoy close-up visual magic, especially anything that has to do with like a soda can, then I think you're really gonna enjoy this a lot. I think that this is the kind of magic that you have to be prepared to do the legwork to prepare it. It's not something that you can just perform on any given day. So it's really for those people that want to put in the time and effort to learn this and to prepare for it, because Most of these effects are going to take a lot of preparation. So if you're not into that, then you're probably not going to like this at all. And I think that what Cyril's main idea was, he wanted to teach you an effect directly out of his television show, and he built the lecture around that. In terms of the last piece, the build production, I think that could have been left out. I think he just kind of added that, you know, just to kind of fill it out, because it doesn't really follow with the flow of the other effects that he goes over. That being said, I think it was a great lecture. I really enjoyed it a lot. Like I said, I would give it a 3 out of 5 stars, because I think he could have taught a lot more details about certain aspects of what he did go over. I felt that a lot of the explanations for the routines in general were done relatively quickly, especially after the first effect. He spent a lot of time on the first effect. And then the other effects, it felt like he kind of was just kind of running through them because he spent so much time on the first effect. So I definitely would recommend this, though, for anyone who is interested in that kind of magic. And I, like I said before, I could see how this would be the perfect type of magic where if you have somebody helping you, you can have that soda can planted and you can go right into this and make it look like an impromptu miracle, literally. So if you guys have any questions about this lecture, please leave me a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I'll see you guys on the next review.